Welcome to this tour of Langfuse Evaluation. Langfuse is a set of open source evaluation tools that covers the whole development workflow from development and in production, and is tightly integrated with Langfuse prompt management and observability. Langfuse Evaluation is designed to work with any model, any agent framework. It's open source and can be also used via our APIs, so you can fit it within your own workflow. Overall, Langfuse evals follows this end-to-end workflow of in offline, so in development, collecting data sets of happy paths, edge cases, and adversarial inputs to then test your application against this data set. So you can loop over different kinds of like agent approaches, models, prompts, and test these kinds of changes against this data set of example inputs to then run offline evals to check whether the experiment that you just made actually like moves the needle into the right direction, makes metrics improve. And here, Langfuse supports a number of different evaluation methods, such as manually labeling data, using LLM-as-a-Judge that can directly run within the platform, or you can ingest any custom evaluation or integrate with any custom evaluation SDK. And usually you do lots of iterations on this kind of offline evaluation workflow. And whenever you want to make a change to production, is you deploy a new version, and then Langfuse Observability helps you to basically capture real user data and debug and manually review traces that are more like edge cases. Here, initially, often teams just randomly sample and do some error analysis on what's going on in production. But as you grow this effort, you want to use online evals to prioritize and monitor for different sorts of error categories. So here, Langfuse supports manual annotation and human labeling. You can queue data to basically schedule them for manual labeling. There's like LLM-as-a-Judge that Langfuse can run within platform, and you can ingest any custom score via API, via SDK, for example, to track user feedback. Here, the main goal is to identify new test cases that you forgot to track within your data sets. And then when you like notice new issue categories, to fix them and then backtest against the data sets that you've defined for your offline evaluation. Langfuse supports this workflow end to end. And all of this is really based on Langfuse tracing, both on the offline side to actually dig into what's going on in these runs, and on the online side for observability to then go from traces back to new dataset items for experiments. I'll now give you a demo of the core aspects of Langfuse evals. We'll start here in production from our interactive demo, and then from here, we'll loop over into the offline evaluation capabilities. When we check out the interactive demo that you can try for yourself, let's prompt for how do evals work on Langfuse? I have a Python app. By now, you know this demo. It's basically like an agent that reasons over the question, can use some tools, and thereby answer questions about Langfuse. So we got a response, and we can add, for example, negative user feedback of this is bad. In the Langfuse UI, we can see the trace that we've just produced, which is a deep dive into what went on in this application in order to generate this response. As we focus on evaluation, let's have a closer look at these scores that are attached to this trace. You can also view them here as a table. You see that we got one API score that's called user feedback, and three eval scores that are called contains PII, helpfulness, and is question. The user feedback API call is a zero numeric with the comment of this is bad. And we have three production evals that are attached by LLM-as-a-Judge in Langfuse that state some reasoning on why they score like this. We'll get to this in a minute. The custom score in this example was directly attached via the front end, via the Langfuse Web SDK. Let's have a look at the docs. You can attach custom scores to any trace in Langfuse via the API or via the SDKs by just calling Langfuse create score, and then to pass in a trace ID, and you can optionally also attach observations, sessions, episodes. This score can be numeric, categorical, or Boolean, and you can optionally also enforce a specific schema of a score. So if you, for example, have a categorical score, you can then define a schema of what categorical values should be available. If you want to attach user feedback, like in the example that I showed you, it's interesting how you get the trace entity to then attach the score. So let's have a look at the implementation that we picked for this example application. This is the implementation of the backend API route that powers the chatbot that I just shown you. And here we call getActiveTraceID, a method exposed by the Langfuse SDKs, to then derive the message ID that is pushed to the front-end code. And in the front-end, we have the feedback components. When we go down, we see we have like our feedback dialogues for like positive and negative feedback, which then handle feedback. And handling feedback basically gets the message ID and the value and comment. And we push this via the score method of the Langfuse Web SDK. In this example, we push this to two data regions because this demo is available in Langfuse EU and Langfuse US data regions, but you would usually just push it to a single data region. Thereby, basically, we asynchronously flag a trace as being like interesting if a user, for example, responds to it. Looking at the trace again, let's focus on annotation, where we can here, when viewing a single trace, can add any sort of annotation score. And basically, in our settings, we can define the different scores that are available and then select them and answer what should be answered for this trace. We can use annotation queues to make this easier as an effort. So for example, let's filter down to all of the traces where a user complaint, so user feedback is zero. And maybe take them from the last 7 days. Now we can batch select all of the traces where users complained and add them to an annotation queue. Let's pick the review user feedback queue. Now we've enqueued these traces for manual review. So a manual labeler can go in, see the review user feedback queue that has some description. In the settings of this queue, we defined which kinds of evals should be applied. And an annotator can just come in and process the queue. And now on the left side, sees the input and output. On the right side, gets to see all of the labels that need to be applied to this trace. And we can also actually leave a comment of, this is great, and complete the next. This is thread safe, and you can basically roll out your annotation workflows to hundreds of annotators if you want to via Langfuse annotation queues. Annotation queues are also available via the API, so you can programmatically enqueue, or you can build your own labeling UI on top of the API without needing to manage the data schema under the hood. In addition to these annotation queues and the custom evals ingested in the API, you can also use Langfuse to evaluate data. Here we support LLM-as-a-Judge, and Langfuse comes with a library of pre-built evaluators. Let's have a look at the trace and figure out what we want to evaluate. We realize that they're like non-English questions, even though all of our like resource documents and prompts are English. So let's build an evaluator that helps us check whether the input and output language are actually the same. So we can set up an evaluator. Here we can now create a custom evaluator for this same language, or maybe it's same language eval. We use the default evaluation model, where we could also define another model that should be used, and can write our own evaluation prompt. Perfect. So now we have a new isSame language evaluator with a very simple prompt template. Usually you would want to give like some few short examples at this point, with two variables, a reasoning prompt that's used for chain of thought, and a score range prompt where the eval should be zero if the two languages are different, one if they are the same, and 0.5 and if unsure or not specified. So let's go for safe. Perfect. So we have the new is same language eval. We can use the selected, can run it on all new traces that are coming in, and we can set some sampling, some delay, and now can insert the different values. I go for trace input and trace output, which is basically is the question of the same language as then in the end the response. And we can hit execute, whereby this eval will now be executed on every new trace. Back in our demo application, let's give this a test. I'm trying a German question of what is Langfuse? we get a response. And I'm following up with some English text to then again prompt for a non-English response. Let's check whether this worked. Back in traces, here's the first question, where the input and output language were different. So please answer in German. Text is a simple instruction in English, and text 2 is a JSON array, including some German response. So yeah, they're not the same. It's 0. And what is Langfuse? Basically, we get the same of the same language. We can now also explore this data on our core application dashboard, where if we scroll down, we can find the distributions and histograms and moving averages of the different scores. This is it for production evals. Let's look into development offline evals. Offline evals are based on data sets that you can create manually in the UI. You, for example, have the QA benchmark data set with items, so you can create new items in the UI. We can upload items via CSV files, or we can push them also via the SDKs or APIs. And when we're in prod tracing and see an interesting trace, we can also from here add two data sets. Once an item is in the data set, this is basically a test case that consists of input, output, and metadata. And we can do experiments or data set runs on top of these data set items. These experiments can either be happening via the user interface or via the SDKs and API. Let's run an experiment via the Langfuse user interface. These use the prompts that are stored in Langfuse. So for example, we have the QA answer with context chat prompt, where there are lots of changes happening, where we use some guidelines to answer a question given some context. So now we can do a data set run. Let's call this test. Test run demo, QA answer with context chat, version 78. We can pick any model that we've configured. So let's maybe pick GP5 mini. And data set, Langfuse QA benchmark. We can see that 4 evaluators have been set up for this data set. So evaluators can be attached to data sets. The variables match the prompt. And we can hit start. This will now create a new data set on the data sets page. This data set now contains a list of different runs, including the latest run that we just made. And we can now contrast these results against other versions, while also being able to plot the different evals at the top that we've configured for this data set. And here we can now contrast the different outputs in like a grid view set of sites. So for every item, basically every experiment and data set run created like one of these cells, including one of the evals and whatever we care about for these runs. And from here, we can easily create like a new run. Alternatively to letting Langfuse run a single LLM call against the dataset, we can also do a custom dataset run via the Langfuse SDKs. Let's have a look. Here, basically, we do a dataset run as a remote dataset run and have an application that's instrumented with Langfuse for tracing and can then get the dataset from Langfuse and loop over it, initiate the context, and then just run the application and optionally add any sort of custom evaluation score to Langfuse. And hereby, we can really test an application end-to-end against the dataset, which can, for example, happen in a CI pipeline to test something every day or on merge to main or also in a Jupyter notebook if you want some rapid iteration on different approaches. This was a very high-level overview of Langfuse evaluations that can be used for online evals, offline evals, and supports all sorts of evaluation techniques. Evals is where most teams spend the most time in Langfuse to really get the application to be useful, safe, iterate on new models, try them side by side, or just test new techniques when they're coming out. And as part of the documentation, you get a great introduction to how these features work. But I would strongly recommend to also explore the different guides that walk you through examples of how to set this up end-to-end. And if you have any questions regarding how to set up tracing for your use case, feel free to head over to GitHub Discussions to ask the community, ask us maintainers for some advice.